promise myself that whenever I am going out and driving alone, don't bring this thought of a flag. One day I realized that yes, I invited that flag.
I called them back.
कोशिश करा तो दांत टूट गया. मैंने मेरे दिमाग में आया कि दांत टूट गया तो कैसे चलेगा. एंड आई फाइंड द सेकंड डे विदाउट डूइंग एनीथिंग मेरा दांत टूट गया.
I'm extremely thankful to Manju ji for bringing me here today. I'm not a doctor. I'm not an entrepreneur as well, but I've worked in the corporate sector for about 30 years, and Manju ji and I. My name is Abha Mehta. And some of the things that I'm just saying resonate, because I think these are some of the distilled truths of life. Whether we give it a spiritual lens and then we go to the BKs or we go to any of the spiritual organizations, we go to Sri Sri and then we listen to them, or we read the Gita and then we introspect and then we say that this is what we gather out of it. The fact remains, whether we call them management principles, sutras, mantras, or success principles, they remain the distilled truths of life. Since ma'am said, share something that is personal to you or that is real to you, there was a slide in ma'am's presentation where she talked about moving away from the comfort zone. I think it's the most difficult thing. And I think it is gender agnostic. It starts even as children, like your daughter didn't want to play badminton because it required hard work. It is gender agnostic. We do not want to move away from comfort zone, especially when the maid doesn't come back and work or takes leave, because I think we are wired that way. Comfort, ease, painlessness are the first go-to that we have as human beings. I talk about myself. I went through a life-threatening illness, 2 episodes, came back, at a time when my husband was forced to write my resignation by my mother-in-law because I had a very small child. But I bounced back and I told myself that doctors can help me, my husband can spend the money, insurance can see me through. But once I come back home, my mother-in-law, my father-in-law, my child are not going to feed me, they're not going to take care of my vanity, they're not going to take care of my dignity. You're going to fight it back. Difficult, because I was in a comfort zone. I had to tell myself that disease can make me physically unwell. I may have to put in some limitations, because every disease has a regimen that you need to follow medically, which is fair. You follow the regimen. That is probably the first time you get out of your comfort zone, because you accept a regimen. And as doctors, you prescribe those regimens to your patients as their well-being formula, isn't it? But that's the first acceptance. Acceptance to disease is also moving away from comfort zone, because your life is not normal. The truth remains that you want to find a new normal. After the economic crisis of 2008, and I belong to the financial services industry, everybody started saying, we have a new normal. Modi ji is now the new normal. We say it in the political context. We all have a new normal. Every 5 years, our own normal changes. She said she was 72, God grant her long life. I'm not 72, but maybe I am worse than her. So age is not a success. Right? It's a number. Sometimes good, sometimes bad, right? Fact remains, don't be in the comfort of your numbers. Other thing that I want to talk about, comfort zone, and she said, no pain, no gain without pain, right? That was really the focus of that slide. One of the things that one of my teachers said was that, listen, we all want to go to the beach, stay at the shore and all you get is seashells, madits, or you know, leftover chappals and jutas, right? Swim deep inside and you're in the pearl. Now if you never want to leave the shore, you never want to deep dive for the pearl. It's as simple as that. The bigger reward do you need, the bigger pain you're going to get. Like you said, being an entrepreneur, not an easy journey. Being in a job, definitely not an easy journey. Being a mother, definitely not an easy journey. Overnight, what happens in the woman's body? 9 months she's carrying the baby, she's being looked after, at least in the economic strata that we belong to. What happens overnight? That she's ready to stay awake. She's willing to move away from her comfort zone. It isn't social conditioning. We keep saying it is social conditioning. Of course, hormones, I know medically you'll say hormones play a role. Definitely they do. But these hormones go away after 9 months or after maybe 2 years. I don't know. So I think the biggest thing is acceptance that to get a reward, you have to dive deep. Sometimes you just skim the surface. Even when you skim the surface, you're not moving away from your hormones. And I'm telling you about myself. If I look at my life, many people say it's a comedy of errors. Many people say it's a tragedy of errors. You know, people, like she said, people criticize. So, getting labels is a part of life. But when I look at myself, the more I think, the more I realize I moved away from my comfort zone fairly early in my life. Being here, standing here today, is another example. Because I think Manju's been trying to push me for about 2 months now, maybe at least 4 weeks. Convincing me, and I've been finding reasons to postpone it. But then one day you realize that you're going to move away from your comfort zone, come here, face the truth, confront it yourself, introspect it or collectively confront it, and then tell yourself, listen, you can do it. Mm-hmm. Moving away from the comfort zone, I think, is the biggest thing for survival. You stand there in the same place, you sit on your bed or lie down on your bed. 365 days later, you'll have one more candle on your cake and you won't have achieved anything. So move away from your comfort zone. I think that's the biggest thing. Thank you.